Let's discuss the chapter 9, Force and Laws of Motion. What do you mean by force? Force, as you have studied in previous class, that force is a push or pull to move an object. But now, in modified form, you can say that force is an external effect which may tend to change the state of an object. State of an object here refers to the state of rest, state of motion, and state of direction. Because force can change the shape and size of object, force may change the speed of an object, force can stop the moving object, and force may move the object which is at rest. So what are the effects of force? Force can move a body at rest, force can stop a moving body, force can change the speed of a moving body, and it can also change the direction, shape and size of a body. What are the types of force we are going to study in this chapter? They are balanced and unbalanced force. Balanced forces, if two forces act on a body in opposite direction, and if both the forces are equal, then the resultant force acting on the body is zero. Such forces are called balanced forces. What does it mean? If there are number of forces acting on an object and the resultant means the total of all the object, all the forces acting on the object is zero, then the forces are said to be balanced. As force is a vector quantity, the sign is the direction is also associated with force. It means if the force is acting in the opposite direction of first force, then we have to put a negative sign in front of the second force. Net force means resultant. Resultant means you have to add all the forces which are acting on an object. Here there are two forces which are acting on an object, that is F1 and F2. F1 plus F2 is equal to 0. It means F1 is equal to minus of F2. Yani both the forces are equal and opposite to each other. Unbalanced forces. If two forces act on a body in opposite direction, and if one of the forces is greater than the other, then the resultant force is not equal to zero. Resultant force, net force, or you can say that the sum of all the forces acting on object is not equal to zero. Or you can say that one force is greater than the other force, then the forces are said to be unbalanced. And you can take the example of tug of war here, that if in the tug of war game, if the winning team means applying greater force than the losing team, it means the forces are unbalanced. And as long as both the teams are applying the same force from the opposite sides, from both the sides, then the rope will not move. It will stand still. But whenever the greater force is applied from the either side, then the forces are said to be unbalanced forces. Force of friction. A force which is opposing the motion of an object over a surface is known as force of friction. As you know that a ball rolling on ground gradually slows down and comes to a rest due to force of friction. Because there is a force acting between the ground and the ball which is in the opposite direction of motion of an object. If we stop pedaling a bicycle, it gradually slows down and comes to a stop due to force of friction. An object with uniform motion will continue to move with uniform motion if all the forces acting on it are balanced. If an unbalanced force acts on the moving object, then its speed or direction of motion changes. As I have told you that unbalanced force may cause the change in the state of an object, whereas the balanced force, they will not change the state of an object. If the unbalanced force is removed, then the object will continue to move with the speed it has acquired till then. That's why force of friction is also known as opposing force. It always acts in the direction opposite to the direction of motion of an object. And if applied force is greater than the force of friction, then only an object can move. इसका मतलब कि अगर आप ज़्यादा फोर्स लगाएंगे किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट पे और वो आपके फोर्स लगाने से अगर चल पा रहा है, तो इसका मतलब जो फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन है वो कम हो गया है आपके अप्लाइड फोर्स से. इट मीन्स ओनली व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट विल मूव और टेंड टू मूव इफ़ द अप्लाइड फोर्स इज इक्वल टू फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन और ग्रेटर देन द फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन. गैलीलियोज एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन एन इंक्लाइंड प्लेन. गैलीलियो हैज़ ट्राइड एन experiment of motion of an object on an inclined plane. He observed that the inclination, if the inclination is less, then the force will be also greater. That's why the ball which is at the less inclination is reached at the top height. Newton's laws of motion. Newton has given three laws of motion. As we have done, there are three equations of motion in chapter motion. Here there are three laws of motion. They are known as Newton's law of motion. Newton's first law of motion states that an object remains in a state of rest or in uniform motion in a straight line unless and until some external force is applied on it. What does this statement means? This statement means that if the object is at rest, it will remain at rest. If the object is in motion, it will remain in motion unless and until some external force is applied on it. And this law excludes force of friction because this is not applicable on force of friction. So what does it mean? Agar koi object rest pe hai to wo rest mein hi rahega. Agar koi object motion mein hai to wo motion mein hi rahega jab tak us par koi bhi bahar se force na laga diya jaye usko rokne ke liye ya fir usko chalane ke liye. This is the statement of Newton's first law of motion, and this law is also known as law of inertia. What do you mean by inertia? It's a new term for you, that natural tendency of an object to remain in a state of rest or in uniform motion is called inertia. It means inertia is a tendency of an object to resist any kind of change in its state of motion, rest and direction. Means agar aap rest pe hain to aap rest pe hi rehna pasand karenge, aap ekdam se motion mein nahi aayenge. Agar aap motion mein hain to aap ekdam se stop nahi honge, aap motion mein hi rehna pasand karenge. This is known as inertia, and I am giving you an example. If a runner is running on a track, there is a finishing line and you will say that you have to stop on finishing line, then the runner will not stop on the finishing line. It will cross it and travel some distance because due to inertia, the runner cannot stop himself or herself from the state of motion suddenly to the state of rest. This is known as inertia. This tendency is known as inertia, and the Newton's first law of motion is also similar to this property. That's why this
law is also known as law of inertia. Examples of inertia. Here are some examples of inertia. If a striker hits a pile of coins on a carom board, the lowest coin moves out due to inertia of rest. You have seen this is very common example you have used in your daily life. If a coin placed on a playing card over a tumbler is flicked with the finger, due to inertia of rest, the coin falls down into the tumbler. When we travel in a car, the driver applies the brake suddenly, we tend to fall forward due to inertia of motion. When we are standing in a bus and the bus begins to move, suddenly we tend to fall backward because our feet in contact with the floor moves forward, but the upper part of the body continues to remain at rest due to inertia of rest. The next topic will be discussed in the next class.